pada tahun 2017, saya diberi mandat oleh Kementerian Pelancongan Seni dan Budaya Malaysia untuk boost satu kempen, iaitu kempen Sayang Malaysia. Bila saya diberi mandat tersebut, saya mencari satu projek yang boleh menyatupadukan rakyat Malaysia sesuai dengan tajuk kempen, iaitu Sayang Malaysia.
Syam approach I dengan Lily masa tu. So, fikir-fikir, so they come up with the idea macam how to collaborate dengan satu brand ni dah pernah buat sebelum ni, which is Kereta Api Sarung. So, we saw the hype, it was like interesting to engage the community, and that's how we think it's the best way to bring community together.
Dipendekkan cerita, saya berhubung dengan Random Alphabet melalui Reza, salah seorang komiti Random Alphabet, yang mana Random Alphabet merupakan pengasas Kereta Api Sarung. Kenapa kami nak take over Kereta Api Sarung daripada Random Alphabet? Kerana Kereta Api Sarung telah berhenti pada tahun 2015 dan 2016.
Random Alphabet, the organisation that was doing the Kereta Api Sarung, they were done with it. They did not want to continue doing it. But we thought that this thing should be continued because it has a sense of unity that we don't see in other events in Malaysia.
Kereta Api Sarung pada saya merupakan satu program yang sangat murni, yang mana objektif dia sangat clear, iaitu untuk menyatupadukan rakyat melalui sarung dan juga untuk menggalakkan penggunaan public transportation dekat Kuala Lumpur.
Kereta Api Sarung was different. It was a community event. It was held by the community, for the community. So we asked the guy from Random Alphabets if we can take the baton from them, and they said, yeah, why not? We are done with Kereta Api Sarung. So you guys take it lah, do whatever you want lah. So that's how lah, we got Kereta Api Sarung 2017.
Dipendekkan cerita, beliau nak saya bergabung dengan salah seorang lagi yang menghubungi beliau sebelum saya. Orang yang saya masukkan adalah Rizwan Nazari, yang merupakan pengarah bersama Kereta Api Sarung pada tahun 2017.
The long story short, kita start berkenalan dengan loko and bermulalah Kereta Api Sarung 2017.
Lepas tu kita orang set meeting lah. So, saya, Lily dan Fiza. Lepas tu Rizwan pula dia dengan Dina. So kita menyampaikan hasrat masing-masing lah. Macam Rizwan memang kata kita orang memang buat Kereta Api Sarung dekat London pada waktu tu 2014 dengan rakan-rakan pelajar-pelajar di London.
In 2014, me and my friends were studying in the UK, and then time tu ada Kereta Api Sarung dekat KL, and they were looking for people to do it overseas. Being in the UK, I was like, how can I join? We had no organisation, we had no macam prior knowledge on event planning or event management, but we thought, how hard can it be? So me and my group of friends started it lah.
Ritz and I came back from UK and we decided to start reorganizing it again.
Saya pun beritahu dekat Rizwan, saya tak ada pengalaman, tapi saya rasa Kereta Api Sarung merupakan satu program yang sangat sesuai untuk kita jalankan bersama. Daripada meeting pertama, kita bersetuju untuk bergabung, and then kita mulalah menyusun strategi macam mana kita nak war-warkan Kereta Api Sarung 2017.
We basically discuss on how we want it to be, how big we want it to be, and how we want the direction of Kereta Api Sarung, and how we can actually year to year better it, improve it and scale it up. Basically, we wanted scalability, so we started small, but now I believe it has grown so big that everybody, every year will be waiting for Kereta Api Sarung.